If you had the opportunity to see what the automotive supply chain looks like, you would notice that suppliers come from all over the globe. Every car, every model is composed of components produced in factories around the world. Rapid technological progress and globalization has made it possible for the OEM, in other words, the original equipment manufacturer, to take advantage of very extensive supply chains and to build a wide panel of suppliers. But there is always something for something. The OEM faces a huge challenge. The original equipment manufacturer must ensure that all components delivered to the assembly plants are delivered on time and in stable, acceptable quality at the same time. And the PPAP procedure is supposed to ensure this. PPAP is the production part approval process used in the automotive industry that originates from the QS 9000 American Quality Standard. This is a set of requirements that must be met by the supplier and presented to the customer before starting serial production. The standard procedure consists of 18 elements. The main aim of the procedure is to provide the customer with the required documentation and parts to confirm the production capability of the supplier. PPAP is therefore a perfect tool for ensuring the quality and quantity of the parts supplied from such a wide supply chain. It will not be a lie if I say that producing for the automotive industry is often the top dream of many suppliers. You will ask why? It stems from the fact that producing for the automotive industry means a fixed volume of orders for a long period of time, hence financial stability. This also means gaining both good reputation and prestige. Would you like to include the information that you had worked for Mercedes, Audi, or Porsche in your CV? Exactly. Similarly, companies want to have their portfolio filled with information about their cooperating with clients recognized worldwide. In order to achieve this, you have to deliver to them, and in order to deliver, you have to prove that you are a trusted supplier, and we will do this through the PPAP procedure. PPAP allows for verifying whether the supplier is able to manufacture a given part at the required quality level. You must know that PPAP has been defined in order to correctly understand the customer requirements and the requirements set out by the design data and to ensure that suppliers' production processes allow for manufacturing a product that meets the customer's quality and quantity requirements on a continuous basis. The PPAP process is a requirement directed towards the suppliers of internal and external production materials, mass production, and service parts. It is carried out in order to obtain proof that all customers' design requirements, specifications, and other needs are properly understood by the organization. The production process allows for manufacturing a product that meets these requirements. Remember that the supplier is obliged to obtain full product approval at all times in the event that the supplier wants to deliver a new product, example, a specific part, material, or color not previously delivered by the supplier to the customer. It is necessary to correct any non-conformities observed during an earlier PPAP submission. The product has been modified as a result of an engineering change, example, in design records, specifications, or materials. If one of the above-mentioned situations has occurred in your plant, it is high time to start the PPAP procedure. Are you ready to receive more details? To begin with, the PPAP procedure is one of the activities defined within the APQP methodology. Do you remember what phase PPAP is part of? Think for a while. Well done! In the product and process validation phase, here we will start the production trial run, from which the items, samples, for approval will come from. If you want to submit the product to the customer for approval, it must be manufactured at the target location using serial tools, materials, processes, settings and measuring instruments, as well as regular line staff. Remember, this is very important. A product submitted for approval must be taken from a significant production run. Such production should last between 1 hour and one shift's production, and the quantity should be a minimum of 300 items. However, the customer may have specific requirements in this respect. In addition, the product process components from every individual process making up a supplied multi-processed component must be approved. Example, multi-chamber housing, injection molds, etc., and representative parts have to be tested. All 18 elements itemized on the PPAP checklist must be fulfilled and made available to the customer for inspection, if they have application. But not all items relate to all products or all suppliers. Such a requirement is the approval of a color and visual aspects. So, if you manufacture parts without any visual requirements, such as color, gloss, or surface grain, this item will not have any application in your case. Non-compliance with one of the PPAP requirements will be the reason for product rejection, process and documentation disapproval, and if the supplier is not able to meet the specified requirements, he or she must immediately contact the customer in order to determine the further course of action and agree on corrective actions.